Welcome back to the One API channel. In the previous video, we've seen a simple SYCL code that can run on a CPU and a GPU. Why is this so important and will only be more and more important in the future? What do we need accelerators for? Why do we see so many silicon options and new accelerators? Take a CPU, for example. I can run many applications and record the performance of each of them. A CPU can usually run everything, any piece of code. But when the workload we're trying to run is very specialized, for example, rendering 3D graphics, our CPU, as powerful as it is, cannot compete with an architecture that was built specifically to execute such a workload. A GPU, for example, you can see in this diagram that a GPU can run a smaller set of applications, a smaller set of instructions, but with much better performance. And we might have an AI accelerator, like Intel VPU or Habana Gaudi processor, that might look like that and can accelerate AI, deep learning training or inference. Or you might have an FPGA that theoretically can be reprogrammed to the range of applications we want it to support. So you might have a bitstream that puts the FPGA here on the left side of the graph, supporting specific set of applications, or another bitstream that supports a different set of applications. And this is why we need accelerators. And the truth is that in order to cover the full range of applications, we usually need two devices, usually a CPU and an accelerator, what we call a heterogeneous system. Each of these technologies offer breakthroughs in power performance, but with that comes a series of complications. Each accelerator architecture carries its unique toolchain. It makes sense. They support different instruction set, different memory maps, and so on. But the result is that all of these pieces of code are different, which means longer time for development, longer development process. It makes it more expensive to move from one accelerator to the other, from one vendor to the other. It becomes more expensive to find programmers with the right expertise, and software becomes the bottleneck. What OneAPI is offering is a unified software environment for all these devices, so you can have one code base for a CPU and an accelerator, a GPU for example. We will explain the software stack underneath SQL and Data Parallel C++ in another video, and there's lots of materials online. But our target is simple, and this is what we will explain during this series of short videos. And it is how to program heterogeneous and parallel systems using SQL with a Data Parallel C++ compiler. In the next video, how SQL can help you program a heterogeneous system. See you there.